If you stream your internet music service from your smartphone or tablet, you're wasting quite a bit of sound quality, according to Auralic. They developed LightningCast to solve this problem. Time to let our ears judge. It has been 25 years since Slim Devices was founded, and with it, unofficially, network audio playback. Systems that followed, like DNLA, Rune and Auralic's Lightning DS, all use a computer running music server program that is controlled from the listening position. That remained the case until music streaming services like Spotify and Tidal Connect became popular. They offer apps for smart devices that can stream directly to your stereo using the DNLA, Chromecast or AirPlay protocol. No computer needed anymore, unless you go for audio quality. Because just like computers, smartphones and tablets by default convert a sample rate of the incoming signals to their internal sampling rate, for instance 48 kHz 16-bit. It's clear that there's no point in paying extra for 192 kHz 24 bits to your streaming services then. But even playing 44.1 kHz 16-bit files sound far from optimal after the sample rate conversion, let alone if you were to use lossy compression to your stereo, such as Bluetooth and AirPlay 2. See John Darko's piece on AirPlay compression. Link in the description. Even if the stream is already of lower quality, like internet radio, the extra sample rate conversion will cause a further degradation of the sound quality, as copying a photo that has already been copied will result in even more loss. And that's not what we want. So if you value high-end sound quality, you need to stick with the server setup, also for streaming services. I myself use Rune, since it lets me integrate my own music library with that of Tidal or Corbus. And because of the unique user interface, of course. It keeps the signal bit perfect as long as you don't use DSP or volume control in Rune. But there are other options. Audivana Core runs on a computer, server or NAS and can be controlled with an app on a smart device. The audio can be streamed using DNLA to a DNLA renderer, and there are many other possibilities. But they always need server software, while young people are used to streaming Spotify from their smartphones, so it's unlikely that server-based streaming will survive over time. Auralic sees another reason why streaming from a smartphone or tablet might become the way to stream from streaming services. They expect the big players to use artificial intelligence to further personalize content recommendations based on your listening behavior. When that happens, customers must rely on technologies like Tidal Connect, AirPlay and Chromecast. Unfortunately, not all streaming service providers have developed their own DNLA-based Connect technology, and neither AirPlay nor Chromecast support high-resolution streaming. AirPlay is limited to 48 kHz and Chromecast is limited to 96 kHz. And from time to time I come across DNLA renderers that are limited to 48 kHz. Let's look what happens in any computer and smart device when a streaming app is used. The streaming app sends the audio to a sample rate converter. Not all sample rate converters are bad, but those you find in operating systems of computers and smart devices are very basic, to say the least. The modified audio signal is then sent to a mixer, so the computer or smart device can play the audio mixed with system beeps and outputs of other apps. The mixer, like the sample rate converter, is a lossy DSP function. The next step is the volume control, yes, again a DSP function, to finally be sent over Wi-Fi to the streamer. To maintain a bit perfect signal, you would like to catch the signal leaving the streaming app lead it around the output circuit of the tablet or phone and send it over the Wi-Fi circuit to the receiving device. And that's what bit-perfect music players on computers do. LightningCast effectively makes sure the same happens on Android tablets. The streaming app output is taken directly from the streaming app, wrapped in a lossless streaming protocol and sent over Wi-Fi to the network player. All the middle ground is skipped and the audio is sent over an optimized streaming protocol instead of a file-based transport. That requires deep access to the program code of the smart device, something manufacturers don't like. What Auralic has done is take a Google Pixel tablet and install Lineage OS 21. This is a so-called ROM that replaces the upper layer of the operating system. The Lineage OS was intended to keep smart devices secure for longer than the 2 or 3 years that manufacturers provide updates for their smart devices. I have no expertise in this field, but extensive research on the internet has led me to the conclusion that Lineage OS 21 has to be the most stable ROM for Android devices. And it's available for a long list of smartphones and tablets. See the Lineage OS website, link in the description. Next, Auralic developed code that does what they wanted. Lead the audio data directly from the streaming app to the Wi-Fi circuits using a streaming protocol, optimized for music streaming. This requires a LightningCast program in the receiving device too, which is the case for all Auralic G, S and X series products running the latest firmware. Additionally, third-party streamers can adopt LightningCast reception using Auralic source code, enabling seamless integration. The 128GB Google Pixel tablet with Lineage OS 21 and LightningCast installed is available from Auralic for €477. For this review, Auralic provided me with one and a Vega S1 streaming DAC. Although being an Apple user, I needed only a short time to get used to the Lineage OS user interface. It's a clean slate, there are no apps installed, but the installation is quite simple. In the Google search bar, enter Title App Download and a simple tab downloads the app and installs it. In contrast to some other ROMs, the Lineage OS can download apps from the Google Play Store without a problem. This means that you can use the tablet for anything you would want to use an Android tablet for. And on the Lineage OS, you won't be bothered by bloatware, apps you don't need but were installed by the manufacturer for commercial reasons. I've used the tablet intensively for a few weeks, did 2 Lineage updates and all worked great except for one little thing, the fingerprint identification. That turned out to be a Lineage OS bug. A user has found a way around it. While training the fingerprint recognition, you have to tap the standby button multiple times with the finger you are going to use to unlock the tablet. If you use one finger, as you would do, you will not be able to complete the process. Just use 2 fingers alternately. With a little perseverance, you will succeed. Plus, you can use both fingers to unlock the tablet. What if you already have a Google Pixel tablet? The press release states, Auralic has developed a complete Android 14-based LightningCast OS system image fully integrated with Google services, specifically for the Google Pixel tablet. As might be clear, I could not try that, and I cannot offer support for those that do. Please visit the LightningCast community if you need support. You find the link in the description. With what streaming app on the tablet will LightningCast work? Auralic published this list. Apple Music, Amazon Music, BBC World Service, Deezer, Adagio, NetEase Cloud Music, Pandora, Qobuz, QQ Music, SoundCloud, Spotify, Tidal, TuneIn Radio and YouTube Music. I've tried the following apps successfully. Cobus, Tidal, Radio.net,
TuneIn Radio,
BBC Sound, Spotify, VLC, Chrome Browser and YouTube. Players that do video lose synchronization between a picture and sound due to the time lapse of the streaming protocol. So there's no practical use unless you want to play music only while using video source. Only podcast.app did not work. For now, only the aforementioned Auralic streamers support LightningCast. But it is open source and the source code is freely available and free for personal use. For commercial use, some agreement with Auralic is needed. Whether other manufacturers will follow is hard to say. Many use DNA but not always support higher sampling frequencies. I think it will largely depend on the license conditions and technical complexity whether streamer manufacturers will adapt LightningCast. As said, I was lent the Vega S1 streaming DAC that was connected over a pair of Scream Audio SQM cables to the Air Acoustics AX520 amplifier. That in turn drives the PMC FAC12 signature loudspeakers on Stack Audio OVA 17 isolators and connected over AudioQuest Robinhood Zero loudspeaker cable. The network connection comes from the Zixel GS1900-10HB switch that was connected to the Vega S1 over a Network Acoustics Eno 2 system Ethernet filter. A Ziggo business modem provided internet access and was connected with a patch cable to the Zixel switch. Also connected here is the small green computer Sonic Transporter i7 CDR music server that simultaneously runs Rune server, Minin server and Audivana core server. Of course I used the Google Pixel tablet running Lineage OS 21 and LightningCast. For comparison, I also used a standard iPad Pro 2. Used with the Tidal app without LightningCast, thus using DNA streaming to the Vega S1, deep lows were absent, resolution was low over the entire band and the stereo image was poor. Only sibilance control was fairly good. When switched on LightningCast, there first was no difference, but after restarting the Tidal app with the LightningCast switched on and selecting the Vega 1, the difference was stunning. The stereo image opened up, deep lows were present and showed very good texture. Resolution was excellent over the entire band. The music was now engaging, emerging, supple and stress-free. Being an Apple user, I now was interested in how the iPad Pro 2 would sound. There's no LightningCast solution for the iPad, but I could play literally the same music files over the iPad Tidal app using DNA, like the initial test with the Pixel tablet. The overall sound quality was slightly better than that of the Pixel tablet with LightningCast switched off, but nowhere near the sound quality of the Pixel tablet with the LightningCast switched on. Using the Google Pixel tablet with LightningCast switch off in this setup, I rate the sound quality in setup 3. With the LightningCast on, it rates halfway setup 1B, so there's quite a distance between them. Let me first applaud Auralic for the initiative. It requires a clear vision of the future, resulting in a greatly improved sound quality when using an Android tablet. It would be nice if installing LightningCast and thus Lineage OS would become as simple as installing an app. On the other hand, Auralic clients might not care too much about spending €477 on a tablet. I use isolator feet under my loudspeakers that cost double. It is funny that Auralic only has a Lightning DS app for iOS, while the LightningCast is only available for Android. Then again, people using an audio server and thus are iOS bound have no need for LightningCast and vice versa. I love LightningCast and the Vega S1 too, so I will post a review within a few weeks of the S1. And on that bombshell, we come to the end of this video. There will be a new video next week. So subscribe to this channel or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn or Instagram to stay informed on when new videos are out. Help me reach even more people by giving this video a thumbs up or link to this video on the social media. It is much appreciated. Many thanks to those viewers that support this channel financially. It keeps me independent and lets me improve the channel further. If that makes you feel like supporting my work too, the links are in the comments below this video on YouTube. I'm Hans Beekhuizen, thank you for watching and see you next week. And whatever you do, enjoy the music.